What does a wind turbine in the Baltic Sea have to do with a classic Nokia 6310? And what does all of that have to do with a greener future? Well, let's find out. I'm Tanisha, and this is Transition Stories. Was not only the year that cell phones looked like this, it's also the year that Spanish energy giant Iberdrola had to make a fundamental decision about its future. Coal and oil, yes or no?
It was 20 years ago when we made the decision on investing in renewable energy, specifically in wind energy. It was also a change in the mindset of our company, but because we were entering into a new field, there was a lot of people thinking that we were kind of crazy because we were investing a lot of money in a technology that it was not competitive from the economical point of view, but we decided it was the moment.
Despite the uncertainty of economic success, Iberdrola CEO Ignacio S. Galán decided to take arguably one of the most important steps in the company's future, investing in wind energy. Wind energy that powers turbines like this one, one part of the Baltic Eagle wind farm, saving the planet almost 1 million tons of CO2 annually, thus consolidating its position as one of the world's largest producers of wind power. We at Deutsche Bank have been supporting Iberdrola for many years, and we're part of their transition story.
Iberdrola is a pan-European utility with a significant presence in other markets as well. Early on, they decided to move to renewable energy technologies and to newer markets. That has really paid off. Iberdrola has had a clear strategy. We like the strategy, and that is why we have become really close partners in terms of doing business worldwide with Iberdrola.
We need energy for almost everything in life. Cooking, baking, having a shower, entertaining ourselves, building houses, creating electric cars. But all this energy consumption creates about 70% of greenhouse gases. According to the International Energy Agency, 29% of the world's electricity came from renewable energy sources in the year 2020, which means that more than 70% still needs to be converted. The World Economic Forum says that that transition will cost between 94 and 162 trillion US dollars by 2050. Trillion. That's a number with 12 zeros behind it. So how will this be financed?
I think we've seen, obviously, in the past, huge investments from the public sector. Now we really need to kickstart the transition and see huge investments from the private sector. Boosting finance to the required level demands a wide range of instruments, and banks will be critical to catalyze this investment. We are a very active bank when it comes to bonds, which obviously Iberdrola issues. We support them with green financing and ESG-linked deals.
So, all good? In a sense. Wind and solar are competitive energy sources today, but the immediate costs of transition are enormous. And it begs the question, is an economy based solely on renewable energy still reliable?
For making the energy system reliable, we really need a mix of different energies, but it's absolutely important that we can store this renewable energy because the wind is blowing whenever it wants. The sun, for example, is not shining during the night. That's why we need to have this energy system fully interconnected. So when the renewables are not available, we have different options, like, for example, hydro, for making like a big battery to store the electricity.
A lot of progress has been made in the energy sector. The International Energy Agency projects that by 2040, renewables will create more than 85% of the world's electricity. That's a long way compared to 29% in 2020.
We fully believe that we are on the track for the energy transition. We have the technology, green technologies, we have the capabilities, we have the resources. So we are in the process of electrifying our economy and making this decarbonization possible.
What Iberdrola has accomplished shows that change is possible when you make bold and courageous decisions. The fact is, switching to renewable energies creates other economic benefits, like creating new jobs, reducing health costs caused by pollution, and improving energy security and independence. Although converting to renewables today is a huge investment, it will bring significant savings in the long term. In this case, Iberdrola has set an excellent example. Hey, did you see our last transition story where we shared how shipping giant Hapag-Lloyd is sailing into a greener future? Click the link below to watch and stay tuned for the next edition of Transition Stories. See you next time.